as young people, we just want to appreciate Dr. Kaunda for the struggle, for the sacrifices he made for our country, as well as for the continent, specifically for the southern region of Africa, for us to be free. Had it not been for their sacrifice, probably even today as we are doing this interview, we wouldn't have been free to do so. So wants to appreciate all the good works that Dr. Kaunda did for our country, for the world, as well as for the sub-Saharan region. Going forward, as young people, we want to make a rallying call to young emerging leaders in Africa to go back to the visions that Dr. Kaunda, together with other freedom fighters, envisioned for Africa. In 1963, when they had the first summit for the Organization for African Union, they envisioned a free continent, as well as a free continent economically, a free continent politically, as well as a free continent economically. Yes, Africa has attained political freedom, but we are far, far away from attaining economic freedom. And economic freedom, according to the way our founding fathers envisioned it, is only going to be attainable through pan-African unity. We stand here proud, as well as equal to the cause. We need, as young people, as we move into the next century, to focus on pan-African unity as a way of economic freedom. Many of other continents are politically free and economically free. Specifically, continents like the US